Samsung's Galaxy S10 flagship phone is absolutely packed full of sexy tech, like an ultrasonic fingerprint sensor and a triple lens rear camera. And it also costs 800 quid here in the UK, which basically means cheese on stale toast for the foreseeable for a lot of tech fans. Thankfully, Samsung has offered up a kind of compromise in the Galaxy S10e, where the E stands for essential. This trims out some of those more premium features, such as, for instance, knocking down the triple lens camera to a dual lens snapper instead, and removing that in-screen fingerprint sensor, and the result is a smartphone that costs just 669 quid. However, you do still get Samsung's latest Exynos chipset packed inside, you get the feature-packed One UI, and you still get that gorgeous dynamic AMOLED display as well. And sure, your wallet will still feel like it's been absolutely molested, but maybe you'll occasionally now be able to afford to add some beans to that cheese on toast as well. The question is though, is the Galaxy S10e actually worth that still rather steep asking price? Well, I've been using it as my full-time handset for the past week now, and here's my in-depth Samsung Galaxy S10e review. And don't forget, for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech, to poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers! So one of the advantages of the S10e over the rest of the Galaxy S10 family is its lovingly compact design. This essential model sports a smaller 5.8-inch screen, and even though the panel doesn't bend around the edges of the device, this still results in a dinky, hand-pleasing finish. Compared with all the 6-inch Godzilla phones I've been fondling lately, this thing is definitely a charmer. And I actually prefer those side bezels in many ways, as it meant less accidental screen intrusion by my palm fat. Unfortunately, it's not all good news on the design front. That ultrasonic fingerprint sensor has of course been replaced with an edge-mounted scanner instead. And while I liked the Sony Xperia edge-mounted sensors, this one has been pushed far too far up that side. It's absolutely fine if you're using the phone with your right hand, as your thumb should sit neatly on top. But if you prefer using your left, like I do, then stretching your finger up and around the frame is anything but comfortable. But at least the sensor does its job perfectly, unlocking the device in a heartbeat once you finally get your digit over it. No complaints on the rest of Samsung's design though. Metallic edging gives way to a simple glass backing with little in the way of visible frills. But you can grab the S10e in the full range of Samsung's Prism colours, including a rather fetching new canary yellow model if you really like to stand out a bit. And thankfully for clumsy buggers like me, that glossy rear is constructed from Gorilla Glass 5, while the display itself gets an upgrade to Gorilla Glass 6. As if that wasn't enough, Samsung has also pre-installed a screen protector, and the S10e is also IP68 dust and water resistant to boot. So basically, the Galaxy S10e is safer than the bloody queen. Sure enough, while that protector picked up a few little scratches over the past week or so, this back end is still nice and shiny, even after plenty of duress. Let's get back to that 5.8-inch dynamic AMOLED display though, definitely one of the highlights of the Galaxy S10e. Samsung sure knows how to throw together a smartphone screen, and this punchy panel isn't just a feast for the eyes, it's a slap-up dinner at the Savoy with all the trimmings. The resolution may have dropped to Full HD Plus for this essential model, but I still found that photos and video were finely detailed, while the HDR Smart, which stretches to the HDR 10 Plus format, means impressive contrast and natural-looking images when you're watching supported content on the likes of Netflix. You can dial down the vibrant output if it's a bit too much for you, but I love those rich colours, especially when checking out some batshit mental anime. And yes, Samsung's screen is powerfully bright on those top levels too, so visibility is no problem even on super sunshiny days. Of course, we do have to address the punch-hole camera, which seems to be strongly dividing opinion amongst fans. Personally, I don't really mind it at all, it rarely intrudes on an app, and it's teeny enough to cause minimal offence even when it does. There's no way to mask it like on the View 20 if you're not a fan, but frankly, it's no worse than a nipply notch thing. The audio chops aren't too bad either. The Galaxy S10e can pump out some fairly full-bodied audio from its stereo speaker setup. And of course, music is a bit tinny, but you can always chuck in a pair of headphones thanks to the 3.5mm headphone jack, and we had no problems whatsoever with the Bluetooth 5 support either. Now on the software side, you unsurprisingly get a slice of Android pie, with Samsung's fresh new One UI squirted on top like a particularly dense whipped cream. This isn't actually vastly different to previous Samsung software, beyond an aesthetic overhaul and a few new features here and there. You still get classics like the Bixby Assistant on board, which as usual can be summoned with a push of that special side button. But thankfully now you can relegate Bixby to a double push of that side button, while a single push will load up your favourite app instead. And of course, Samsung's stalwarts like the Health app and SmartThings hub for your connected home gadgetry are present and correct. I particularly like that SmartThings integration, as you can fast access your smart bulbs and other bits directly through the Galaxy S10e's notifications panel. The presentation could be improved, sure, but it definitely does the job. And you even get Samsung's edge screen shortcuts here too, despite the fact that the Galaxy S10e doesn't actually have an edge screen. confusing. The overall design of One UI works really well, with the ability to customize pretty much every aspect of the software to your precise preferences. You can't ditch Bixby, unfortunately, but I actually really like the new Bixby Routines feature, which allows you to set up if this then that style rules to govern the Galaxy S10e's behavior based on all kinds of factors, from your current location and the time of day, to which Wi-Fi networks and Bluetooth devices you're actually connected to. There are simply tons and tons of features to run through, far too many to even busy mention in this review here, but if you want a more in-depth look, then go check out my full One UI tips and tricks guide over on TechSpert. So what about the performance? Well, the Galaxy S10e sports the same Exynos 9820 chipset as its bigger siblings, although the base model has just 6GB of RAM compared with the 8GB S10 and S10 Plus. I say just, but 6GB is of course absolutely fine for everyday running. Apps load reasonably quickly, and only very occasionally did I see the Galaxy S10e stagger a tiny bit during busy moments. And yes, the likes of PUBG Mobile play on top detail levels with no signs of lags, so you can blast through a game with that competitive edge. And Samsung's gaming mode also lends a hand as well, stopping notifications in their tracks and allowing you to record your bloodiest kills, complete with full mic support as well, if you like to bestow amusing insults upon your fallen foes as their brain matter splashes across the ground. Unfortunately, the Galaxy S10e can get a wee bit toasty during those intensive play sessions, usually after just half an hour or so. Not to particularly troublesome levels, but you'll definitely notice it growing hot in your hands. And in my week with the Galaxy S10e, I also noticed a couple of little crashes as well, hopefully just early jitters that'll be ironed out very shortly in a Samsung update. Battery life, unfortunately, is our major bugbear with this phone. That 3100mAh cell is swiftly drained when the Galaxy S10e is in use, and if you're regularly checking messages and messing about online, you'll only just about have some charge left when you stumble into bed. Try anything more intensive and you'll be making full use of those battery saver modes in no time at all. The fast charging isn't particularly fast, but the Galaxy S10e does at least support wireless charging, and you can even charge up other devices with Samsung's blower using the power share feature, which is kind of like Huawei's reverse charging on the Mate 20 Pro. But with battery life this limited anyway, frankly, who wants to share? Now last up is the camera tech, and yes, as mentioned before, the Galaxy S10e sports just two lenses instead of the customary three for the rest of the S10 family. That primary lens is a 12 megapixel shooter with a dynamic aperture, which can change on the fly between f1.5 and f2.4 to match the lighting conditions. And this is backed up by a 16 megapixel f2.2 ultra wide shooter, which offers a 123 degree view of whatever you're aiming at. Sadly, that third telephoto lens is missing in action on the S10e though. Boo. To see exactly what we thought of the Galaxy S10e's camera chops for photo and video quality, go check out our in-depth Galaxy S10e camera review live right now. So in conclusion, while the Galaxy S10e commendably boasts the same premium chipset, feature-packed UI, and pretty much all the same slick visuals as the rest of its family, it also loses out on some of the more character-defining aspects. The ultrasonic fingerprint sensor and that telephoto lens are a definite miss, while the S10e's meager battery life also causes some consternation. Considering the price point here isn't that far off the excellent Mate 20 Pro, it is rather tough to recommend Samsung's supposedly essential phone. Even if the software is for the most part excellent, the media chops are top notch, and I definitely love that compact finish. So what do you think of the Galaxy S10e? If you're tempted by the standard S10, but it seems to be a little bit out of your price range, is the S10e a good compromise, or is it still a bit too pricey? It'd definitely be great to hear your thoughts. Definitely bang some comments down below, and don't forget to poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Have yourselves a lovely week, peeps. Woo!